Hello and welcome to Fearless DIY Music. My name is Tristan Lass, and today I want to talk about what you can do as a musician or a creative when you have no budget to buy anything. I find myself in this situation all the time where I sell a guitar, I have a certain amount of funds, I end up spending those funds to, you know, buy other gear or another instrument, and you know, you do end up in these like dry spell periods where maybe you just have no cash whatsoever, but you start getting the itch to, you know, have something new or something that feels new. So I wanted to talk about some of the ways that you can, you know, kind of refresh things or feel like you're doing something, or if you're a project-oriented person, things that you can do when you have very little budget to no budget. And let's just go through some of those ideas. All right, my first idea is that you just do some cheap mods to your guitar or any instrument that you have. Now, let's use a guitar as an example. You can, you know, buy a new pick guard for it. If you have a, you know, a Strat style guitar, go ahead, get a different pick guard for it. On this particular guitar here, I'll hold it back up. I took the existing pick guard, which was gold anodized, and I painted it white, because I wanted to just kind of change this guitar up and give it a different look. Simple things like that. Getting new plastics for your guitar, you know, changing up the knobs, new pickup covers, things that are relatively inexpensive and will kind of dress up your instrument and make you feel as if, oh, you know, it just feels kind of fresh and new. There's also the simple way of going through your electronics and maybe changing a capacitor, which costs almost nothing, or just, you know, altering your wiring a little bit just to, you know, kind of make the instrument custom, and once again, give it that kind of fresh feel. All right, this is a critical thing for anybody who works on instruments or has, you know, two or three or more, you know, instruments at their disposal. When you do mods to them, don't throw any of the old parts away. I have bin after bin and little, you know, containers like this just filled with all kinds of parts from over the years that I salvaged from instruments, or that, you know, I replaced parts on a guitar, and I always keep all the old stuff. Pardon me for, I just dropped that because it wasn't gonna stand on end. But anyway, I keep everything. Keep every single screw, keep every washer, keep every nut, keep old machine heads, even if they're broken. Sometimes you can salvage the parts and refresh your current instrument just using little bits and bobs that you have accumulated over the years. It is invaluable. I don't know how many parts casters I've made where I've saved tons of money by already having most of the screws and most of the necessary hardware already on hand, just because I never threw anything out or got rid of it altogether. Same goes for pickups. The worst pickup in the world may someday come in handy, especially if you just want to rewind it. You know, that costs next to nothing except for the wire and your time, and you can actually take a crappy pickup and make it into a good one. All right. Another huge thing that you can do with your instrument, if you have no cash, is just give it a really deep clean. Take everything apart, clean it up, put on some new strings if you have strings on hand, and give it a full like adjustment. And I find that sometimes just doing that will really bring guitar back to life, and you can fall back in love with it, you know, since it just feels newer, it feels clean, and it plays perfectly. That's another great thing to do if you're low on cash. All right, this is a huge one. I find that when I have no budget and I can't be bringing new stuff in, I go through and I find all my broken stuff. I mean, all of us have been there. You know, maybe there's a jack on a guitar that needs to be replaced. Maybe there's a bad pot on an effects pedal that you have and you've been living with it. Go through and just make those simple repairs that are relatively inexpensive. And if you, you know, keep all of your old parts, you may already have all the parts on hand that you need to do those repairs. It's huge and it feels good. It feels good to resurrect things that have been broken. And, you know, you don't, you already own it. You don't have to spend hardly any money on it. So that's a huge thing for me. I do that about once a year. I go through and I gather up all the things that I've been meaning to get to and just go ahead and hunker down and do all those minor repairs. All right. Now, if you want to get some cash, you can do what I'm kind of like toying with right now. I'm beginning to create a sell list because I feel like I have a great collection of instruments, but there are a number of them that I'm not playing and don't see a need for in the future. So if you want to bring new things in, a great way to do it is to sell what you have. Don't sell anything that you're emotionally attached to. Don't sell anything that you think that you might have a use for. But if you've pretty much ruled out the fact that you're not gonna ever play the instrument again, or a pedal, or an amp, or whatever, get rid of it, get that cash, and then you can go and have the fun of searching for something new. All right. I did this during the COVID epidemic when that first year when people were locking down. I locked down as well. I had no cash. And what I did was is I scavenged a bunch of wood and I did a couple scratch builds. I built a couple guitars from scratch. I built, an amplifier cabinet from scratch. This is another great way, especially if you have lumber laying around or you have access to decent wood, you can do some scratch builds, even if it's as simple as building, a basic body or going ahead and, taking a crack at your first neck. They're very time consuming projects, and that's what's great about it. They don't cost you much money. It's going to be a lot of time and a lot of effort, but the reward is huge and your expense is relatively low compared to like buying a brand new, really nice neck from Warmoth. You could make your own neck and go through that process. And it's a great learning experience and it doesn't cost you much except for the lumber. And sometimes you can get that for free, which is the way that I kind of went about it. I was lucky enough to scavenge. And if you scavenge enough, you can find good tone woods out there. All right. Another thing that I like to do is I take things that are laying around and I'm just like, this isn't much good to me. Like sometimes I have some enclosure boxes with a bad, circuit in them. And I'm like, well, what am I going to do with that? And what you can do is just repurpose things that you have laying around that you're not currently using in their current form. What I like to do is I'll take, an effects pedal, and I'll take it apart and turn it into an AB box, or I'll turn it into, an amp switcher. There's all sorts of little projects like that that you can do. And if you're like, wow, I would really like, I'd like a Y splitter, and you just take an old enclosure, throw some jacks in it, and boom, there you go. And it's a fun project, and it's actually a utility box you may use more than you ever would have used otherwise in its previous form. And then finally, I'm not a huge fan of relicking, like buying a relict guitar. You spend all that money for something that's been beat up. And I get the process and I understand why they're so expensive and they can be super cool. I'm not trying to take a big crap on relict guitars on the market. However, if you want to, you can take an instrument and you're like, let's say I think about relicking sometimes that Squire Strat right there. It's all polyurethane. It's a great guitar. It sounds fantastic. It already feels good. However, I think that it would feel way better if it had some age on it, or if it felt like it had some age on it. And relicking that myself costs nothing. And you can experiment. If it's a relatively inexpensive instrument, why not? That's another great way to do a project that's not going to cost you anything. And that's it. I just wanted to throw some ideas out there. I know that, the ebb and flow of cash in a musician's life can be very, very unpredictable and the dry spells can be long. That does not mean, though, that you have no options. And I just wanted to throw some ideas out there for those of you who are on a stretched budget or no budget, so that you can feel like, oh, well, maybe I'll move forward on some stuff, have some fun with it, and see what you come up with. All right. If you made it this far into the video, I would appreciate a like and a subscribe. Shares are greatly appreciated. And as always, leave something in the comments. Tell us about, you know, some of the projects you've done on no budget. And we'll all be inspired to do something new. All right, you take care, hit subscribe, and we'll see you next time.